Hi, this is Freddy from Switzerland with another knife review, and today we're going to take a look at a new brand for me, which is called CMB Knives. You can see that here on the packaging, CMB Made Knives, which is a newer Chinese-made company, a bit like Best Tech and Wii Knives. They came a bit out of nowhere with their own brand here, but they have been making OEM work for a longer period of time, and judging from the knife I have here, they certainly know what they're doing, but they have a very similar feel to, for example, an older Best Tech or even some of the newer ones, but they are very impressive in terms of overall quality as far as I can judge from the model I have here. They have been releasing, I believe, 5 different models, very different designs, different price points as well. This one here is one of their higher-end models featuring some higher-end materials, and we're talking about the CMB Made Spear model. There are 2 different versions of this available. We have this one here that comes in a plain stonewashed titanium with a stonewashed matte finished blade and these very nicely done shred carbon fiber inserts with blacked out hardware. And then there is a fully blacked out version available with black handle as well as a black blade. And these are the only 2 versions that come in the Spear model. And both of the versions feature S35VN steel, as you can see right here. And the design is an in-house design by ZMB Blades. So very interesting overall design. This is certainly also a larger knife. You will see that in the size comparisons. Very good in terms of ergonomics. But first off, let's talk about the specs on the CMB Spear, which is certainly a very, very gorgeously looking and very aggressive looking folder here from CMB Knives. So we have an overall length here on the CMB Spear of 21.2 centimeters or 8.34 inches with a blade length of 9.2 centimeters or 3.62 inches, a blade stock of 3.5 millimeters. The steel, as I said before, is S35VN at a Rockwell harness of 60-62 as claimed by CMB Knives, and then we get a spacious handle of 12 centimeters or 4.72 inches. In terms of weight, on this nice folder we have 115 grams or 4.06 ounces, so in terms of ratios a little bit heavier than its blade length, but it certainly doesn't feel overly heavy. It feels nicely balanced, and you will see how they manage to get the weight down a little bit here on this particular model, because I think it's a very interesting overall construction that they have chosen here on this knife. You can also see that the blade to handle ratio is nicely done in terms of using the space that they had. The blade tip goes all the way back here, and also the centering is perfectly executed here on the Spear. In terms of pricing, this one comes in just under $260, and these CMB knives are actually available at whitemountainknives.com. You will find a link to that store in the description, and there you can use my discount code 7Ready to get 10% off of your whole order. So you can order any knife, something from CMB or anything else, and you will get 10% off your entire order while using my discount code 7Ready on the checkout at whitemountainknives.com. Thanks again to White Mountain Knives for supporting the channel, and it would help me quite a bit if you use that code while ordering some new knives right there. So thanks again for that, and don't forget to follow me on Instagram at 7Ready_knife_reviews. So having all that out of the way, so under $260, pretty substantial overall size, great materials with titanium and S35VN. And if we take a look on the inside of this knife, you will see the very interesting way of inlay work that they have done. So you can see that the carbon fiber scale inlays go actually all the way through. With that approach, they certainly save a little bit of weight. And then you have these screws right there on the edges of the inlay that actually secure it in place, probably in addition to some industrial epoxy. So very nice kind of full thickness inlays that they have done here on the spear right there. Also, we can see we have captured ceramic bearings in there with like a brass casing. We also get a ceramic detent ball, stainless steel lock bar insert with over travel stop. So certainly all the ingredients are there for a high-end full titanium frame lock flipper. We get a 3D mil titanium pocket clip that is rather long and also has good springiness to it and works really well, carries about like this in the pocket. In terms of action here on the CMB spear, you can see very nice and smooth. In terms of detent, this is on the medium to light side of detent, but that is of course also done so it's easily operated via the also included opening hole. You can also spidey flick it, but that needs a bit of practice because you don't have a huge amount of access, even especially here from the lock bar side. It's even a little bit more occluded then from the show side right there, but you can do it if you go in the upper area here of the hole, and then you can spidey flick it quite easily. You can also thumb flick it like that, and of course the flipper is the main opening method that this knife was designed for. You can misfire it if you slip up because there is no chimping here on that flipper tab, but it's a good size and very comfortable to actuate, so it's also not that big of a deal. In terms of detent, as I said, it's in the medium territory, nothing super strong, but it's very, very secure in there. You cannot shake this knife out, so absolutely no issue there in terms of detent. Just if you prefer a super strong detent, at least this version of the spear that I have here is more at the medium to light end of the detent spectrum. In terms of ergonomics, left and right-handed, very, very comfortable. All the edges and corners are very nicely chamfered and rounded. We also get a little bit of a overall contour on the carbon fiber and titanium there. Get a nice backspacer with some more aesthetic jimping here on that backspacer. One screw construction and milled out pocket on the pocket clip there. Absolutely no hotspot from that pocket clip in any grip that I tried so far. So really well done on the pocket clip. Unfortunately, we get the lock bar cutout on the outside. You know, I would love to see them always on the inside just to give it a more clean overall look. But other than that, no issue with the lock bar or the lockup strength. You can see here how the blade locks up right there. Also very good access to the lock bar for disengaging the knife. Absolutely no issue. Nice chamfers, as you can see right there as well. Just a very, very well executed knife here. And if you take a look at the blade, which is super, super gorgeous, very aggressive, looks a bit like a fighter jet or something. Nice aggressive swedge at the top. Pretty high flat grind right there, coming to a nice and thin thickness behind the edge. Very nice and symmetrical sharpening job right there. Very thin and stabby tip. So certainly nothing to pry with, but to get into packaging, opening up things, this is a very, very good tip that we have here on the spear, and it certainly honors its name here with being called spear. So a very nice and pokey tippy blade that certainly will serve you well as a utility cutter. And it's just a gorgeous overall design. I like the overall design of that inlay. You can also see that the inlay work has been done very nicely. And also the quality of that carbon fiber is really well done. So no real voids to speak of. Nice chatoyants in the carbon fiber. And of course we get the inlay on both sides, which I certainly really like. I don't like when the two scales of a frame lock look completely different and you don't only have an inlay on one side. So they have done that very nicely here. Some good cut out here in the inlay for the hardware. Also minimal hardware, just three screws. We have a T8 for the pivot and then T6 for the pocket clip body screws, as well as the inlay. Another cool thing is that they actually use the back body screw to be the pocket clip screw, so they saved one screw By that design choice, also we get a decorative non-tooled pivot here on the show side. So overall, a very cool design. Lots of things done correctly. You can also see that we only have a small kind of CMB logo. I probably would go with only the logo and on the pivot screw when you have that nice non-tooled pivot screw as you have it here. But as it is done, certainly nothing that takes away from the blade. Otherwise, very sterile, only the very small S35VN marking that is done very well. You can also see that you have some chamfer on the pivot there, on the flipper tab right there. One thing that I'm not a big fan of is that you actually can see the detent track because it has a slanted down handle scale design, but that is certainly a very minor nitpick. And now let's do our size comparisons that we do here on the channel. So we have the CMB spear right there in the middle and do our standard Shirogorov sandwich. So we have the F95NL, and you can see very similar in overall sizing, a tiny bit smaller right there. And then we get our Shirogorov Neon Zero, which is one of my favorite EDC blades in existence. And you can see it certainly slots in the middle between the two, but certainly quite a bit closer to the F95NL. So certainly a larger knife in terms of the things that I have in my collection. You can really see that these two are very, very similar in their overall sizing. The spear is thinner overall. You can see in terms of blade length, you get a bit more on the F95, but certainly in terms of sizing, very similar. So it's certainly a full-sized folder here with a blade length of over 3.5 inches. And then we have our benchmark EDC blades that we do all the time. We have the Para 3 as well as the Benchmade Bugout in Micarta, full-size Bugout here. And you can see it's certainly substantially larger than both of these knives. So let's do some other comparisons that are more in the overall idea of a larger frame lock flipper in titanium. For example, we have the Bestech Vibra designed by Kombu. And you can see that these are very close in overall size, but the spear is larger and has an overall a larger footprint. And then we have another Bestech I reviewed recently, and that is the Isham Design Medium Reticulum, which is also going to be a bit smaller, as you can see right here, but very much in that overall size territory of a bit over a 3.5 inch frame lock. In terms of thickness, we can see a bit thicker than a reticulum, for example, also a bit more substantial blade stock. And then I also have a US made titanium frame lock to compare it to, and that would be the ZT-0609, the best ZT ever made in terms of production ZTs in my opinion. But you can see that the spear is quite substantially larger than the 0609 right here. So certainly a full-sized folder, fits great in my hands. You know, I have small to medium hands, 7.5 sterile glove. You can see at least one additional finger here on that handle. So even if you have very large hands, this will fit you really well. Good clip, very good action. Medium to light detent, but still works great for all the different opening options that you actually have here on the spear. Also including the Spidey flick. Very, very comfortable, good guard from that flipper tab. Also, nice sharpening choil and grind that clears the plunge grind. Nice and thin and very uniform grind on that blade of S35VN. Of course, for the price that they charge at $259, I probably would like to see an upgraded steel in terms of something along the lines of M390. Or something a bit more interesting than S35VN, which is certainly a great powder metallurgy steel, certainly a premium steel, but has lost a little bit its air of super premium character that it had in the last couple of years just because of all the new things that have been coming out. But it's certainly overall a great material mix that we get offered here with the CMB spear. Love the inlays. I think they really dress up the overall design, and the way that they did the inlays here, with it being full thickness and also adding in the reduced weight Also here this little cutout for your index finger landing zone is done very well. So overall a very well made full-size titanium frame lock flipper here from CMB, and certainly a company to watch to see what they do in the future. I hope you liked the review. If you did so, please give it a thumbs up and follow me on Instagram at 7ready_knife_reviews and subscribe to me here on YouTube. If you want to buy some new knives, please check out whitemountainknives.com and use my discount code 7ready to get 10% off your entire order. And as I said before, CMB knives are available at White Mountain Knives, so check out what they have on that website. Everything will be linked in the description below. Thanks for watching, have a nice day, and goodbye.